with us right now, Mr. Yes. Ahmed Johnson. Thank you very much for joining us, Ahmed.
Hey, how you doing, Todd?
There
how
he
you
is.
Doing, Sonny?
Hey, how you doing?
We've been having some trouble with our phones, so thank the Lord you can hear us okay.
Yeah, I hear you good.
Obviously, there's two sides to every story. We are going to have Faarooq and Clarence Mason live on the program in just a few minutes, but I want to get your side of the story. Tell us exactly what went down. There's a lot of rumors. Faarooq is saying, opposite things of what you're saying.
Yeah.
And everybody knows now the 2x4 incident, you and Faarooq. Tell us exactly what happened.
Well, Todd, first of all, my loyalty's to the pack, and I don't have to lie about anything. Faarooq came in the locker room. I was in there just, you know, chilling out and watching the matches. He came in over 2x4, and what he didn't know, being at education level when he went to the third grade, is that I saw him in the mirror coming behind me. Mm-hmm. So I turned around and grabbed 2x4, and I hit him with it across his head and across his ribs and his leg.
Well, that's the part that Gorilla Monsoon saw on video, which led to your suspension.
But, Sonny, you know that. It's like Rodney King thing. If it wasn't on video, it would never have had a, if Rodney King incident was never on video, it would never have been acquitted.
You can only
go off what you see, and I understand that. I'm not mad with Monsoon. He's seen what he's seen, but he didn't see the whole story.
Right.
And I'm telling you the truth, what happened. And if he wants to suspend me in the pack for 30 days, whatever, so be it. But I'll be back. You never know when. You never know where.
Maybe even by Survivor Series.
Well, let's bring out the man who we're talking about right now with his representation, Clarence Mason, along with Faarooq on the Livewire here this week. Ahmed, I'm sure you have a couple of things to ask these gentlemen. Making their way to the Livewire. Gentlemen, thank you for being here on Livewire this week. We appreciate it.
Mr. Mason, how are you?
Faarooq, how are you? Obviously, you heard Ahmed Johnson telling a different side of things than what you're saying.
Heard Ahmed Johnson. You know, would I expect anything else from a coward that comes out and steal me from behind? No, I wouldn't, okay? He knows in the neck of the woods that there is no fair play in love and war. And, oh, by the way, you're getting out of speaking of Rodney King. You remind myself of Rodney King. No, can't we all just get along? No, we all can't just get along. You know why? If we could get along, we'd all be one color. And that is the difference, brother, between you and I. I know this. You don't. But you will find out.
And Mr. Pettingill, we don't need you to insult our intelligence. The bottom line is this. You saw the videotape, and everybody else here in the World Wrestling Federation saw the videotape. No one ever saw Faarooq with a 2x4. We only saw Ahmed. That was it.
Let me tell you, Mr. Clarence Mason, let me tell you something real quick. If you ever get your buck 05 ass in my way, boy, I'm gonna beat
no,
you.
No, like no, see, no, no.
That's an assault, and that's punishable by jail time.
No, see, it ain't like that. See, no, no, see,
you, Fruit, you was good in your days, brother. You was an icon, if that's what you want to call
Dave,
yourself. You know,
no.
I hear a lot of people on TV talking about,
hey, you got it wrong. You got it wrong. This is my day. Who's laid up in a hospital bed injured? Who has a ruptured kidney? It's not Faarooq. It's you, punk. I put you out. Your days are the one that are gone. And look, you know, see, it's people like you, man, you know, that remind me of an old uncle of mine, you know, and his name just happened to have been Tom. Until all of the Toms like you are wiped away from here, then people like myself will show you really what's supposed to happen in the World Wrestling Federation and on this planet, okay? See, it's people like you, bro.
Fruit, bite out to a player that's greater than you, dog. Let me tell you something real quick about you. You icons, okay? You're an icon.
You got that right. Yeah, that's right.
Okay? But let me tell you about icon. A 57 Chevy with an icon, chump. You think a 57 Chevy can hang with a brand new Viper?
All right.
You ride on my you're
an
icon.
A car
like some other people I know.
You're a car
icon
now, right?
What it used to be.
You're a car now instead of a wrestler, right? See, that's
the problem is he's part of the establishment, and all that's about to
change
very soon.
Obviously,
I'm telling you, Clarence Mason, you better shut your mouth, boy. I'm gonna come out there.
No, you won't do nothing.
I mean, gentlemen, obviously we're not gonna solve this here on Livewire. Many more discussions on this issue. Obviously, we're gonna be right.
What's it gonna take to undo this much damage?
Oh my!
Well, obviously, each gentleman tells a little different version of what you just saw there. Ahmed Johnson, very upset, and during the commercial break, unfortunately, hung up. He had had enough, and apparently did not want to hear any more from you gentlemen.
Surely he's had... No, he hasn't had enough yet. He's going to get enough, though. He's going to get all he can stand of Faarooq, okay?
Look, the bottom line is, ever since his inception here into the World Wrestling Federation, he's had problems. Partisan rulings on behalf of Gorilla Monsoon. It came as no great surprise to myself when he was only levied a 30-day suspension. It's obvious he's in cahoots with Gorilla Monsoon, but that's okay. He's been hoodwinked, he's been bamboozled, and he's been misled and mistreated.
Well, see,
but it's a new day. It's a new day, and all that's about to change. The answer is the nation.
Well, see,
the nation of domination.
The nation of domination is absolutely right. And see, that falls under the category, like you say, he's in cahoots. No, what I call that is a clear case of brown nose butt kissing, okay? That's what we've got to get away from. That's what the nation of domination stands for. And until I obliterate all of those Uncle Toms,
exactly,
like Ahmed Johnson, okay, then things will smooth out here. See, under the nation of domination, this is not dealing with just a particular sect of people or a particular group of people or a certain race of people. This dealing with all people.
Everybody.
You've got people out there that are too lazy to get out their butt, waiting for the people to come out and give them handout supplements, waiting for the man to come by and tell them what to do with their life. But hey, then you, on the other hand, got people think certain people can run fast, jump high, eat watermelon, like fast cars, listen to loud music. No, that ain't what this is about. This is about the new nation of domination, okay? And under this nation of domination, I will come into your neighborhood, your home, your house, and mold your child like I want them to be. Forget those old minds and has-beens,
okay? The perfect role model.
I am what's happening now. I am the future of your child.
Well, it seems to me that the actions of Ahmed Johnson have finally unleashed the true spirit of Faarooq. Why don't we find out what the callers think about Farouk's new insight?
And with all due respect, I would suggest that Ahmed Johnson is not an Uncle Tom.
Do you know what an Uncle Tom is, Doc? No, I don't think you really do. You can't, okay?
All right, let's take some phone calls and find out what the people think. Lola from Pennsylvania,
Lola,
you're on Livewire.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning,
Lola.
I hope everyone had a very happy Halloween.
Thank you.
I see that Clarence Mason and Faarooq are still in costume. Clarence Mason, you need to take off that Faarooq outfit, okay? The Louis Farrakhan. Faarooq, you are trying to look like Jim Brown, which you will never be.
Honey, look.
For one, this nation of domination you claim is phony.
Hey,
you're
look,
phony.
Let me tell you
no,
something.
No, let me tell
you. No, you're
you
on the
something.
Phone and everybody is beautiful on the phone, okay?
One, you
know,
are
first
very
of all,
bizarre.
I don't have to look like anyone. I am who I am and what I stand for, okay?
What
that's,
you
let's get
stand
that straight.
For is
forget the Jim
that no
Brown and the Farrakhan. I said the
life.
Nation
you
of domination. You didn't hear me speak of anything
want you
else.
To ever mold anything
and, ma'am, I want you to understand one thing. I don't hang on anyone's coattails. I stand on my own laurels.
You need
what?
To get a
shut
life
up.
Of your
shut
own,
up,
see? You know, that's what you need.
Your little narrow.
You need a life. You need a life, woman. That's what you need. And see, you know, and before long, you will be in this nation, okay?
Well, Lola, we'd like to thank you for your call. Let's go to Pete in California. Pete, are you with us?
Yes, I am.
Hi, Pete.
How you doing this morning?
You have a question?
Yeah, Mr. Faarooq, I'd like to know, what's with that the symbol of that headgear that you wear into the ring? I'd like to know what that is.
Okay, well, look, hey, first of all, let me put it to you like this.
Okay.
It's like when I get up in the morning, okay,
yeah.
If I look into my closet, whoever I feel like being or whatever I feel like doing that day, that's who I am, all right? And
what
then
happens?
Secondly, you know, that isn't any of your business what I come out there with. And if you have any problem with that, if you got any litigation you need to go through with that, then talk to the man here. Otherwise, don't waste my time.
Well, the man that's next to you, see, I'm from California, and I know a lot of phony lawyers, and that wannabe Johnny Cochran next to you, this guy is a leech. And you know what?
Let
you
me tell
better
you
off with Sonny.
Johnny Cochran has nothing on myself.
You were better
I'm
off with
I'm totally
Sonny.
Undefeated in a courtroom of law. I've never been defeated.
Well, you know what, Faarooq? What goes around comes around.
And I hope you come around my way, okay? Because you will get something that Ahmed is going to get.
Thank you, Pete, for the call.
More of your phone calls on this issue as Livewire rolls on here this week. As a matter of fact, you never know what to expect here in the World Wrestling Federation. If you were in Richmond last night, the World Wrestling Federation was absolutely rocking. We're going to be in Washington this afternoon.
That's right.
Landover Arena, it's mm-hmm. incredible. And here's where else the World Wrestling Federation plans on stopping.
It's big, it's bad, and it's coming. The World Wrestling Federation's Big Bang Boom Tour is exploding with nonstop action and excitement as it sets to blow the roof off an arena near you.
This afternoon, we fly into the U.S. Air Arena. Tomorrow, we take over Worcester Center. Monday, we go north of the border and hit the Halifax Forum. On Tuesday, we invade the St. John's Memorial Stadium. Wednesday, we make our way to the Center 200. Thursday, we pull into the Harbor Station. Friday, we shuffle into Buffalo. And next weekend, we've got two great dates in Milwaukee and Cleveland. The World Wrestling Federation is exploding with action. And you can be at ground zero with the WWF Big Bang Boom Tour.
Looking back in time,
a scary skeleton
is being brought to you by Foot Action. For every action, there's Foot Action.
And by Sega Saturn, because you just can't beat the system.
Oh, you're right. Also, Sunny, by the U.S. Army. Look for the Army hyperlink on the WWF AOL site in the TV Zone section to find out where you can be all you can be. And indeed, you are watching Livewire, your program totally live here on USA. It's the World Wrestling Federation. Clarence Mason and Faarooq, our special guests here today, announcing the Nation. I'm going to get this correct now.
Absolutely, the Nation of Domination. And let me tell you, Todd, why the Nation of Domination has come into existence. When you look at the video and you see what was perpetrated upon Faarooq.
Absolutely.
This is outrageous. This is ridiculous. A 30-day suspension. It's obvious we're not going to get any justice here in the World Wrestling Federation. So you know what we're going to have to do? We're going to have to take matters into our own hands. We're going to have to look out for one another,
you see,
thus the nation.
You see, what it is this, okay? You can't get anything through litigation, through red tape, through politics, okay? See, under the Nation of Domination, what I have always stood for, you get it by force. By any means necessary, you take it. That's what I advocate. That's what my teachings are. That's what my followers will do. That's what they've done all along. And we will grow like wildfire spreads through California. We will be in your neighborhood, in your neck of the woods, in your house. Your kids will see a new role model from this day on.
Why, Todd, I wouldn't be surprised if I got a call from your kid wanting to be part of the Nation of Domination.
Speaking of calls, let's take one from Rob in Ohio.
Rob.
Hey, Todd.
You're on.
Todd.
Yes.
Got a question?
How you guys doing?
Good.
Hey, Faarooq, let's cut the crap. Ron Simmons, I followed your career from the time you was a Florida State Seminole. You was in the NWA, you was with Doom, you was the tag team champion. You even went on to be NWA champion. Now, what's this?
Hey, no, you cut the crap. Hey, that life, what you saw of Ron Simmons, hey, was just as you say, was outstanding.
He's new and he's improved.
And I appreciate you calling in saying that. And by the way, this one from this day forward will be nothing less than that. Oh, you know, what you got to do, brother, is learn to address me as Faarooq from this point on, okay?
All right, let's talk to Bryce from Indiana. Thank you very much, Rob, for your call. Bryce, you're on.
Yeah, how's everybody doing?
Good, thank you.
Yeah, Faarooq, this question's for you. Just like the guy before you said, I followed your career. I totally respect that we call you Faarooq, but like I said, I do know that you were an All-American at Florida State. You were the first WCW Black Heavyweight Champion, plus the Black Heavyweight Champion, first one in the world. And, you know, do you want to follow your legacy as Ron Simmons, or do you want to be called Faarooq from now on?
Look, he got in contact with me, and I officially went through the legalities, and I changed his name to Faarooq. And that's how he's going to be addressed from now on, Faarooq.
Absolutely.
All right, thank you very much for your call, Bryce from Indiana. Lots more Livewire still to come here this